Chinese beef steak people. Or nas and not as. A monster that is people. Wow. It's massive. The devil.
Left in our life. stays with me like a haunting melody.
Now we go with this piano, guys.
Just a quick down. We'll get told off.
Campaigners are calling for tougher powers to protect historic empty properties in danger of decay. Conservation groups in Stoke-on-Trent say part of the city's heritage is at risk because the owners of important buildings aren't maintaining them or can't be traced. And they've won the backing of a local MP. Laura May McMullen has more.
An iconic symbol of Stoke-on-Trent's industrial heritage, the former Price and Kensington pottery factory in Burslem, now in a sorry state, derelict and further destroyed by a deliberate fire earlier this week.
It's really horrible to see so many important buildings that are part of people's heritage, part of their lives, in such a rotten mess.
And we really want it cleaned up now so people can be welcome to the city.
You come past this and you think, what the hell am I coming to?
These campaigners are calling for action. The Grade 2 listed building is privately owned, but last year the council had to step in to demolish its historic frontage for public safety. The landlord was fined £1,000.
We started this process about 5 years ago now. The owner's not been negotiating or speaking with the council. He's not been willing to work with us. So we've been working with the local MP about changing the law, because that's what needs to happen for us to take harsher line on such property owners.
We want the council to take more action with the owners, maybe a bit more responsibility there, and they need to have bigger fines. A £1,000 fine is not enough for these people who own places like this.
We've made numerous attempts to contact the landlord, but had no response.
I'm bringing a 10-minute rule bill on the 22nd of September to make the fines unlimited so judges can determine how serious they think the damage is done and therefore what type of fine should be put onto the owner.
Price and Kensington has been on the Heritage at Risk register for more than 20 years. These campaigners say enough is enough. Laura May McMullen, BBC Midlands Today, Stoke-on-Trent.
To sport and Wolverhampton Wanderers.
What's happening, guys? How's it going? Today we've got this place. There's loads of cranes, old cranes and all sorts of stuff left in a massive shed. Well, I see mucking his hair, Miss Lee, it's not.